Marathon runner's cardinal sin. 6 months, maybe more. 5 a.m. alarms. Long runs in the freezing rain. Countless miles that have shredded your shoes and tested your will. Social sacrifices, strict nutrition, pain, doubt, and finally, the peak of your preparation. You've banked the miles, you've built your aerobic engine, you feel ready. And then, 2 weeks before the big race, the panic sets in. This panic is your greatest enemy. It's the voice that whispers, "You didn't do enough." The voice that says, "Maybe I should squeeze in one last 25K run?" Or, "Maybe I should push the intervals a little harder?" It's the voice that convinces you that rest is lazy and that your fitness will evaporate if you don't continue to punish your body. Let's be crystal clear. Giving into this panic isn't just a mistake. It's sabotage. It's spending 6 months building a Formula One car and then, in the final 2 weeks, deciding to pour sugar in the gas tank. Tapering, the strategic, scientifically designed reduction of training load, is not optional. It is not rest in the passive sense of the word. It is the most critical phase of your training. It is the process by which your body converts fatigue into fitness. If you believe the last 2 weeks are for building fitness, you have already lost the race. The fitness is built. The final 14 days are for sharpening. And here's how science explains why less is finally more. The science of supercompensation, why tapering works. When you train hard, you are essentially causing damage to your body. During recovery, your body doesn't just repair this damage, it supercompensates, rebuilding itself slightly stronger than before. The marathon, however, requires a massive cumulative effort over months. This accumulated effort creates a deep systemic fatigue that 1 to 2 rest days cannot erase. This is where the 14-day taper comes in. The goal is to drastically reduce accumulated fatigue while maintaining maximal fitness adaptations. The research is ruthless on this. 1. The glycogen battle filling the premium tanks. The infamous marathon wall, usually around kilometer 30 to 35, mile 18 to 22, is not psychological. It is a violent biochemical crisis, the depletion of your muscle glycogen stores. Your body stores this premium fuel in your muscles and liver. Hard training constantly empties these stores. Tapering is the only strategy that allows for glycogen supercompensation. By drastically reducing your mileage, you stop burning through your reserves. By continuing to eat adequate carbohydrates, especially in the final 3 to 4 days, your body loads these tanks to 150 to 200% of their normal capacity. Classic studies by exercise physiologists like Costel showed that a proper taper can increase muscle glycogen stores by 20 to 40%. This is the difference that pushes you past the wall. Running a 20K long run 1 week before the race? You just emptied the tank you were trying to fill. 2. Muscle repair and enzymatic action. Every long run, every hard workout, creates micro tears in your muscle fibers. This is good for long-term adaptation, but devastating in the short term. Markers of muscle damage like creatine kinase, CK, are sky-high after hard training. The final 14 days allow these markers to drop back to baseline. Your muscles are literally rebuilt. Inflammation subsides. You arrive at the start line with muscles that are 100% repaired and ready to perform, instead of muscles that are already at 80% capacity, carrying the damage from the previous week. 3. The hormonal revolution, ending the cortisol reign. Chronic heavy training puts the body in a catabolic breakdown state, dominated by the stress hormone cortisol. High cortisol breaks down muscle tissue and suppresses the immune system. Tapering reverses this. It drastically lowers cortisol and improves the testosterone to cortisol T/C ratio, favoring an anabolic building state. This is why so many runners get sick immediately after the marathon, but it's also why a proper taper keeps you healthy before it. 4. Hematological and neuromuscular gains. Research, particularly from the guru of tapering, Inigo Mujica, has shown that a proper taper can increase blood plasma volume. More plasma means better thermoregulation, cooling, and a higher stroke volume for the heart, more blood per beat. Furthermore, your neuromuscular efficiency improves. Your muscles become poppier and more economical. The final verdict. Studies consistently show that a well-executed 2 to 3 week taper improves marathon performance by 2% to 5%. In a 4-hour marathon, 3% is 7 minutes and 12 seconds. In a 3:30 marathon, 3% is 6 minutes and 18 seconds. This is the difference between a strong finish and a collapse at the final 5K. The tapering paradox. Cut volume, keep intensity. Tapering is not stopping. It is not jogging slow every day. Stopping completely equals losing sharpness. Continuing full workload equals arriving exhausted. Your goal in the final 14 days. Fatigue down, down, down. Fitness maintained. How? Cut volume sharply. Keep intensity exactly the same. Example. Wrong. I'll just run 10K easy instead of intervals. Right. I'll do the intervals but fewer reps, same pace. The 14-day battle plan. Race day equals day 0. Week minus 2, days 14 to 8 before race. Volume, 60 to 70% of peak, last medium. Long run, 16 to 18 kilometers, 10 to 11 miles, easy. One quality session, reduced reps, same pace. Other days, short easy runs. Week minus 1, days 7 to 1 before race. Volume, 30 to 40% of peak, no long run, one short quality session. Carbo load Wednesday to Friday, 8 to 10 grams of carbs per kilogram body weight. Final 48 hours. Friday, rest or 20-minute jog. Saturday, 20-minute shakeout plus 2 to 3 short strides. Don't overeat Saturday night. Taper madness, this will happen. You will feel heavy, you will feel slow. You will think you've lost fitness. You will get phantom pains. None of it is real. This is the spring being compressed. On race day, it will explode. The truth. You can destroy 6 months of preparation in the last 14 days. Tapering isn't art. It's precision execution. Running coach Demetris, master of science in sports science.